food chains. Food chains are all around us, in nature. They help us to understand how different living things depend on each other for food. Imagine you have a garden with some plants in it. You might see some bees buzzing around and some butterflies flitting about. They are visiting your garden to eat the nectar from your flowers. Now, what do you think happens when a bird comes along? Well, the bird might swoop down and eat one of those buzzing bees. This is an example of a food chain. Plants make their own food through photosynthesis. Photosynthesis is like a magical process that helps plants make their own food from the sun's energy, water, and air. Bees and butterflies eat the nectar from plants, and birds eat the bees and butterflies. Food chains can get even longer with many different living things depending on each other for food. But it all starts with the plants, which are the base of the food chain. Every food chain starts with a plant because plants can make their own food from the sun's energy. Animals can't make their own food like plants can, so they have to eat something to get their energy. That's where the food chain comes in. Let's look at a simple food chain. The sun shines on a plant, and the plant makes its own food. A caterpillar eats the plant for energy. A bird eats the caterpillar for energy. A snake eats the bird for energy. So, the plant is the first thing in the food chain because it starts the energy flow. Then, the caterpillar eats the plant. The bird eats the caterpillar. And finally, the snake eats the bird. Each living thing in the food chain is called a link. If one link in the chain is missing, the whole chain can be affected. That's why it's important to understand food chains and how all living things are connected. A food chain has three main parts: a producer, a consumer, and a decomposer. The first link in a food chain is always a producer, which is usually a plant. Producers are able to make their own food using sunlight, water, and nutrients from the soil. The second link in a food chain is a consumer, which is an animal that eats the plant, the producer, for energy. Consumers can be divided into two groups: herbivores, which eat plants, and carnivores, which eat other animals. The last link in a food chain is the decomposer, which breaks down dead plants and animals into nutrients that can be used by producers to make new plants. Examples of decomposers include bacteria, fungi, and worms. Every living thing in a food chain is important, and they all need each other. Plants make food first, then animals eat the plants or other animals. And decomposers help break down dead things into nutrients for new plants to grow. We hope you enjoyed learning about food chains. See you next time. Goodbye.